Since we're unable to take a field trip to the landfill together, what I'll do is create a landfill at home. And I've done this in the classroom before with Play-Doh, so I invite anyone who wishes to follow along at home with some sort of moldable substance to follow along with me. So here's our nice site where we're now permitted to build our landfill. So we'll get rid of whatever was going on there before. And the first thing we'll need to do at our site is add some infrastructure. So why don't we build a road? And we can have a little bit of an equipment yard here. I'm gonna give us a little scale house on the way in. We'll have a little blower skid and a flare for our landfill gas collection system. I'll give us a leachate treatment facility, and here's an equipment shed. There are multiple pieces of infrastructure that must be in place for our landfill to operate. Now our main part that we'll need is the landfill itself. So I'm gonna pick this area here is gonna be my first cell that we'll build in. So we'll just excavate some of this material and I'm gonna stockpile it here. We're gonna need this later. So we've got our first cell excavated. The sides are sloped for the required geotechnical stability, and the bottom's been graded to drain the leachate to this end. And that's where we are going to pump our leachate out once we've got our leachate collection system attached. The first thing we'll need to put in is our liner system. I'm going to construct a liner that follows one of the designs in the Ontario Regulation 23298, which uses compacted clay with an HDPE liner on top of it. So I'm gonna pipe in some clay. So I've constructed my compacted clay liner on the bottom and on the sides. I've left this side open so that I can expand this way in the next stage. So I'm now gonna put in my HDPE liner. So this is actually a piece of shopping bag, which is also HDPE. Liners are a few dozen times thicker than this, but it's the same material. So this is gonna go on top of our clay. This top edge is meant to be secured with an anchor trench. So together, this plastic HDPE liner and the clay underneath it are gonna stop, or at least slow down the leachate from penetrating into the groundwater. Now the leachate that's on top, we wanna easily take out. So like we mentioned before, we're gonna grade our leachate in the bottom towards this point where we're gonna pump it out. But to allow the liquid to easily flow that way, we're gonna install a leachate collection system. And for this, we're gonna use two layers of geotextile, which is gonna be this paper towel with a layer of gravel in between. So this just protects the HDPE from the gravel. And there's just going to be a thin layer on the bottom and the sides. So I've got my leachate collection system on top of my liner. It's going to carry all the leachate towards this little low point in our design. So that's where we're going to pump out our leachate from. So I'm going to use this blue string to model our leachate pipe. There's going to be a pump at the bottom of this pipe, and we're going to trench it a little path over to our leachate facility. We'll add one more piece of infrastructure before we actually start filling our landfill, and this is similar to our leachate header pipe. Here is a header for our landfill gas. So we'll dig a trench from the blowers and flare here, and it'll go all the way around the landfill. And I'll use an orange string just to show a different color of header pipe than the leachate. Okay, now that we've got our liner, leachate collection system, and landfill gas header installed, we're gonna start filling the waste. So we'd have our trucks coming in here, going over the weigh scale, and we actually need to build them an access road down into the landfill. The first lift of waste that gets put on the leachate collection system is going to be pretty loose as a protective measure. So we'll have trucks driving in, dropping off this waste. But we do really want to compact this material as much as possible to maximize the life of our landfill. So once this material is in, the next layers are going to be more compacted. So every load of waste that comes in is going to be driven over and compacted by the operators as it goes in. And every day, at the end of the day, they're going to have to cover over all the waste that was placed. So from our stockpile, we can apply cover over our waste. And then the next day, we'll add more waste. We'll keep adding. So as our cell fills up, we're going to do two things. One is start getting the next cell ready to expand into. And one is start closing the parts of the old cell that have been filled up to the permitted elevations. So I'm going to excavate as well as start closing off this side of this cell. So in our closed portion here, we haven't put any landfill gas wells in yet. So I'm going to show you on this side vertical wells. So we can go to our closed portion and we can drill a well down into the waste. And then we'll just need to collect the well to the header with a lateral pipe to be able to extract gas from that location. And we'll space our wells throughout the mound so that we're getting good coverage throughout the waste. So as we need to expand our landfill and open new sections, we'll use a similar construction to construct a liner system and extend our leachate system and our landfill gas system. And on this side, just to show you the difference, I'm going to do a horizontal landfill gas collection trench. So as we are landfilling, instead of waiting till the end to put in these vertical ones, we're going to trench across and put on these horizontal ones as we go. Once the second cell is complete, we can start closing it just like we closed the first section with our stockpiled material. So now we've closed off both cells. You can see that the vertical wells leave all the wells sticking out on top, whereas you can't see them as well as the horizontal ones. As our landfill ages, all our springy waste is going to settle down and our landfill is going to kind of compress and settle. And then we might even be able to come in and do a vertical expansion on top, where we might do more lateral expansions out as we get more and more waste. So I'm quite constrained in my little tray. I don't have any room to expand out, and that's a pressure on landfills everywhere, is a lack of room for new sites or expanding sites. And it underlines the importance of doing everything on top of the landfills in the waste hierarchy before we get to this point.